since we don't have a quorum, but we will have very happily after a few new members are sworn in. So at this point, I'd like to turn the meeting over to Joseph Curran.
Thank you, President Lex. And as you mentioned, we don't have a quorum yet, but we will have one momentarily when we get a couple of new trustees sworn in. And it is my pleasure to first call up Ms. Lily Louie to take the oath of office. Along with...
The sound's feeding through the TV. 7 seconds later. So you can't swear. Oh, she didn't give you a copy of it?
No.
Yeah. Okay, so it's down here.
Yes, sir.
And then when you're done.
Oh, good evening, Honorable President and Chair of the Library Trustees and Vice Chair, Commissioner Shabunka. It gives me great pleasure to appoint to the Library Board of Trustees of Ms. Lily Louie, and I am deeply honored to administer the oath of office to her. Okay. Ms. Louie, would you kindly raise your right hand, please? If you would repeat after me.
Okay.
I, Lily Louie.
I, Lily Louie.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
And that I will bear true faith.
That I will bear true faith.
And allegiance.
And allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution.
And the Constitution.
Of the State of California.
Of the State of California.
And I take this obligation freely.
And I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And I will.
And I will.
Well.
Well.
And faithfully discharge.
And faithfully discharge.
The duties upon.
The duties upon.
Which I'm about to enter.
Which I'm about to enter.
Congratulations, Ms. Louie.
Thank you.
Now, I think, oh, there's
Mr. Do you want to have a ceremonial pen?
There's a ceremonial pen.
Oh, there's a ceremonial pen.
No. And it has to be in blue ink.
I'm sorry, I have a purple pen.
Purple?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mix it with the red one. We know our primary colors.
Okay.
And with that, I invite Ms. Louie. Take a seat.
Oh,
okay.
Trustees.
Again, congratulations. And is there anything you would like to say to your fellow trustees?
Yes. Okay. Thanks to Mayor Sylvester and our Daly City Council for this opportunity. I look forward to supporting our library community and working with all of you in the future. Thank you.
Any place you want.
And here's your pen, sir. I'll leave it right here. Okay.
And next, Ms. Alyssa Reyes and Vice Mayor Jocelyn Manolo.
Good evening, President Lex and Vice President Shabunka.
Good job.
And I just want to say I'm honored to give the oath to Alyssa Reyes. I believe, you know, she is one of our youngest Board of Trustees and is at Westmore at the moment and is excited to serve. She utilizes the library along with her peers. So raise your right hand. I, Alyssa Reyes.
I, Alyssa Reyes.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
That I will take this obligation freely.
That I will take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well.
And that I will well.
And faithfully discharge.
And faithfully discharge.
The duties upon which I am about to enter.
The duties upon which I'm about to enter.
Congratulations. I want to say a few words.
Thank you to Vice Mayor Justin Manalo, to Mayor Sylvester for appointing me to this committee, and I look forward to working with the rest of the committee. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Well, on behalf of the two Board of Trustee members who are here before you, welcome. We'll look forward to your service, your interest, your commitment, your engagement, not only at our meetings, but with the libraries and the community and with the community members, and help us to sustain and improve and build and support the libraries in the important role and mission that they have in the community. I would like to offer you the opportunity to just make a few personal remarks about your background before we get started in the formal meeting in terms of, you know, your interest in libraries and serving on the board. So since you were introduced first, Lily, I'd like you to start.
Oh, sorry. When I was a young child, I grew up in a poor family, and the library was my savior. I hung out in the library after school on the weekends and all summer, and we couldn't afford anything. So I lived all my dreams and learned everything through reading lots of books. I mean, back then we could check out 8 books a day, and that's what we did, and we hung out in the library. This was in the Chinatown Library, and it's not as nice as they are now, but it was home to us, and with mentoring from the librarian and our teachers, it motivated us to carry on our education in school and all the way through high school and college, and that's what we need to do with our young kids nowadays, is get them to read. I'm sorry, but with my daughters, it was very difficult to get them to read, because, and unfortunately, that's the foundation for them to learn. I'm very fortunate that somehow, somewhere, my daughters did do well in school and went on to complete college and have decent careers. And I feel that I would like to help our young students. I did a lot of tutoring and reading for my kids' school, and I'm there for them in whatever they need. Fundraising, I did a lot of fundraising in schools. So just a little of my background. I worked 40 years in finance and accounting, so I can help in that too, because I work for the San Francisco Redevelopment Agency in a lot of budgeting, funding, and everything. So we're all here to work together in whatever capacity that's needed. Thank you.
Thank you, Lily. Lisa?
So a little bit of my background. I'm currently a student. I'm a junior in Westmore High School. And a lot of our students, we're encouraged to use the library as our number one resource, even over the internet, because that's really where we do a lot of our research. We make friends. We have a lot of valuable information in our libraries, and that's why I wanted to serve in this committee. A little bit more about myself is I'm very active in California High School Democrats. I'm the regional director for NorCal, and I'm also part of youth organizing groups, which is why I'm I'm very politically active, and yeah, thank you.
Well, thank you. Let me thank the members of the audience, first of all, for being here, for supporting nominees and friends and family. It's a nice turnout, and I'd like to recognize Mayor Sylvester, Vice Mayor Manalo, President of the Jefferson Elementary School District Board, Marie, and Pam DiGiovanni, and Paul McGonum, who's a supporter of Daly City Public Library Associates, and sister, yes?
Daughter.
Sorry.
Sorry, Leanne.
Daughter of our, yes, Leanne, my apologies, of our newest trustee. So with that, I'll officially call the meeting to order. This is the regular meeting of the Daly City Library Board of Trustees, Tuesday, February 21st. We're open for business. The first item will be Pledge of Allegiance to the Flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May we have a roll call, please?
You certainly may. Trustee Reyes.
Here.
Trustee Louie.
Present.
Vice President Chubanka.
Here.
And President Lex.
Here. Thank you. I would entertain a motion to approve the minutes of our previous meeting, which you should have a copy of, dated January 17th.
You skipped the
Did I skip one?
Approval of the agenda.
Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you very much, Joseph. Let's go back one step. I will entertain a motion to approve the agenda for tonight's meeting. Would anyone care to?
I make a motion to approve the agenda. Have you two had a chance to read the?
I just had a chance to glance at it.
We've had a motion to approve. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded. All favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Any opposed? Okay, the minutes are approved. Excuse me, the agenda is approved. I want to get those minutes out there. Okay, moving on, we have the minutes of the January 17th meeting. I request a motion to approve those minutes.
I will have to do that and second them as well, right?
Move and I'll second.
Oh, I didn't think you could.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that the minutes be approved. All in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? Motion passes. Okay, into the business of the meeting, director's report, item 5, senior outreach. This was an item that we brought up a couple of meetings ago, I think.
We did indeed.
It was a suggestion by a community member through Susan Brissenden-Smith of Daly City Public Library Associates, and one that we wanted to explore. So,
and we went off in a couple of different directions, if you remember mm-hmm. that. On the staff side, we were thinking more delivering books to homebound people who couldn't physically get to the library. We had a member in the audience that day, Ms. Schwarzbach, whose desire was not exactly that. It was either to get her to the library or bring lots of books for her to peruse at home. So there were a couple different iterations of that. We've taken a look at what some of our surrounding libraries have done, and at this point turn over to Chayla with a little report and see where we go.
So as I mentioned at the last meeting, we had sent an inquiry to our neighbors in the other PLS libraries, and it actually generated a great deal of interest. That was early on in the process when we were looking at a mail service, because some sort of mail service, it's something that San Francisco does, and it seems like something that would be much more easy in terms of getting off the ground and getting it running. So they are proceeding with that. There was uniform interest throughout the peninsula, and we will definitely be trying something like that. It is something that I have received requests for, and I know that our circulation manager receives requests at least a couple times a year as well. So we're happy about that. And then based on Mrs. Schwartzbach's feedback from last time, I know this is not really what she was interested in. I asked one of the staff to look into which other agencies or community groups we might be able to partner with. However, I was feeling that it would probably be best to have some service to offer before we reached out so that we could publicize that service and at that point in time gather any information about what other library services people who are homebound are interested in receiving. So what we'd like to do at this point, what we're proposing, is to move forward with the mail service.
Okay, any questions or comments from board members?
No, but I'm glad we're moving forward on something like that.
Yeah, I agree. That's a good step in the right direction. You mentioned you were going to do some additional exploring of ideas that might address Mrs. Schwartzbach's interests more directly. Can you bring those back to the next meeting? Is that enough time for you to develop that?
Well, we're as far as providing a some sort of transportation service, the only portion of that we would be able to provide at this time is just information and referral to something like Ready Wheels.
Or yeah, if I can chime in at this point,
sure.
Too. Certainly a lot of our regular visitors to the Dolger Senior Center have either voluntarily or for medical reasons no longer drive, and a fair amount of them do arrive by Ready Wheels. It's a service of the San Mateo
Sam
County
Trans
Transit
provides
District.
That, doesn't
yes.
It?
It's something you need to qualify and apply. It's not picking up the phone and saying I need a ride. Right. But once you qualify, you can take it to point to point within the county. Mm-hmm. And that's a service that maybe we need to help promote.
Mm-hmm.
Now those familiar with it, certainly a lot of people are, because I see literally every single day at Westlake Park their shuttles coming through. But it might not be something, if you're not in the know with that particular group, maybe it's worth promoting to let folks know that this is something that is subsidized by the taxpayers in the San Mateo County Transit District. Mm-hmm. So that was another thing that we talked about. Again, it sounds like in Mrs. Schwartzbach's, and I don't want to speak for her, but it was, you know, there was bringing books to her that she could peruse and pick, or conversely bringing her to a library. So it's probably easier to let the transportation piece be handled by the transportation professionals, especially with our limited staff and the fact that the entire library division doesn't have a vehicle. Makes the transportation piece a little bit tricky.
Right.
But it's...
Mrs. Schwartzbach was temporarily homebound, as I recall, and was missing her contact with and access to the libraries,
mm-hmm.
and was asking if we couldn't think of some way to address people with that kind of need. So the Ready Wheels probably wouldn't help, as Joseph has said, with a situation like that. If you're homebound, you know, transportation to the senior center isn't going to mm-hmm. solve your problem. So I would invite our new members to continue to think about ways that, you know, we might be able to have outreach to seniors and let me know if you've got some ideas, because we can bring it up and put it back on the agenda and get some staff input.
Do we have any volunteers that would be able to offer that type of service to our?
That was a model that was happening in South San Francisco, I believe.
Until they no longer had a volunteer.
It's tricky to program exclusively with volunteers. One of the other pieces of the dialogue that we didn't go over too is the catalog is online, and that's why if they have internet access, and I know not everybody does, but for those that do and are used to you know, perusing the catalog that way, the most cost-effective way for us, the least staff-intensive delivery method would be through the mail. Now, the problem with that is, with the United States Postal Service, which is the most affordable option, you would have to, someone from staff would have to bring the books to the post office, because you can't, I forget what the weight limit, over a certain weight, you can't just put it in outgoing mail. It has to be processed person to person at a post office. Now, we understand in San Francisco, they did get a variance that we've tried reaching out to our postmaster locally. We've not been successful. It's something we can certainly continue to do to see if that would certainly help quite a bit if we didn't have to transport books. I mean, if we're going to take the books to the post office, it might be just as easy to take them to somebody's house. So we're hoping to eliminate that piece.
Or possibly be able to tap into the metered mail service that the city is using.
That
because
would be
metered mail will bypass that requirement. I just learned that.
I have a thought.
Learned something new today.
I did too.
High school community service hours.
Right.
Is that anything that maybe could be something that we use, get the high school kids involved in dropping books off for the elderly? And I mean, if that's
assuming they drive and have access to
well, assuming they drive, of
course.
Right.
But you know, you'll find seniors running out of things. You know, they procrastinate, like I know I did in high school, and suddenly they have 50 hours. Is that something that maybe they could volunteer at the library to drop? You're going to find kids looking for stuff to do to spend those hours. I don't know.
So I definitely believe that some high school students would be up for it. It just depends on like if they can drive or they have a vehicle.
And is there insurance? I know we have
right.
to think about that. But it's something that maybe, because Lily, when you brought up the volunteers, maybe it's something that kids could spend their time helping seniors and vice versa.
And then assuming there is an actual demand. And we've heard from one resident in how many years have you been
who
here?
Had spoken with her friends, though. So, you know, it's something that
if
it's planned and it's talked up, maybe it's something that we could.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, and if there's not much demand, then there won't be much requirement for service, and there won't be much of a burden, you know, on the library or the staff or volunteers.
Yeah. But, yeah.
You know, I know Mr. Sylvester, the mayor, has a real interest in senior citizens and volunteer activities, and you know, I want to take advantage of that commitment on his part to serve Daly City residents through the libraries as much as possible. Any other comments or thoughts? Okay, so Shayla, let's continue this item on the agenda for the next meeting for an update in terms of the books by mail option and when that might be implemented and some of the other ideas that we've discussed tonight.
Okay,
great, thanks. Okay, moving on to item 6, California Public Library Advocates Board Effectiveness Training.
So this was continued because we have so many new members. We had previously scheduled a training for March 4th.
Right.
However, actually the trainer reached out to me to recommend postponing it. They do have an upcoming, it's their annual spring workshop that's taking place in Mill Valley. And she wanted to recommend that anyone who could would attend that and possibly rescheduling the training in the month of May. That was what she thought might work best. It would let everyone get their feet and go through the orientation that takes place within the city itself.
Is that happening the same day as the 4th?
Mm-hmm.
Is that happening?
No, she was suggesting rescheduling it and not doing it on March 4th, instead doing it sometime in the month of May.
But you're talking about the Marin County thing.
Oh, that one is April 22nd.
What's the date?
April 22nd.
422.
It is a Saturday at the lovely Mill Valley Library.
So if you're not able to go to May one, can you still attend a March one?
It's actually something that's custom done for us, and she would come to, I think, to meet with us, so probably we wouldn't schedule it twice.
Oh, okay.
But we can, in May, we can work around your schedules. It would be on a Saturday, though. She does them 9 to noon on Saturdays.
Oh, because I have a scheduled trip to Belize.
Wow, that sounds
my hometown.
Possibly even more fun.
You guys want to come?
Would you be gone for the whole month? Or?
About 3-4 weeks.
We'll
have the meeting down there.
Yeah, you come with me.
Problem.
Haven't been home in 50 years.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Well, Lily, how about giving me your your available dates in May?
Okay, sounds good.
CC Chayla.
Okay.
And then we can see if that's a suitable date, for our trainer. In the meantime, can you get a little more information about this meeting in Marin, Mill Valley?
Yes.
That we can share, send out by email or
I'll send you the link to the website for the organization. It's the California Public Library Advocates. And as a member of this body, you are a member of that as well, because this group has been, the membership has been paid.
Yeah, I would encourage everyone to think, about attending that, just to be around other people and other library systems and to hear about the ideas and the things that they're doing and to be among a professional or a group of professionals devoted to libraries. It'd be really worthwhile, I believe.
And you'll report back? I have to work.
Well, yes.
Good.
The team will. I'm hoping I won't be the only one. All right, any other comments or questions about that? All right, item 7, potential measure AK, projects for the library. This is a request we made at the last meeting, asking the staff to come back and talk to us about items that could be submitted under measure K that would support the libraries in one of many different possible ways.
Thank you, President Lex. It is something we spoke briefly about this morning at the Daly City Public Library Associates meeting. And one of the challenges for Daly City in reaching into that Measure AK pool is the matching fund requirement. As you know, if you've been following Daly City in the last several years, our funds have been extremely tight. So the last go-round for applications, not because we didn't have the need, we didn't have the match. We were the beneficiary of $100,000 of about $350,000 it took to upgrade the bathrooms at Ceremony. Our laundry list of needs is quite extensive. For example, if you were at the Ceremony Library this morning, you may have seen some of the leaks that we've been battling ongoing over there. It's becoming a little bit problematic. We've been fortunate that we haven't lost any equipment yet, but that's fortunate. It was purely luck. Water is strange. It enters at one point and then it finds a path. And
it will do that.
And it doesn't ever come out in the same place twice. We have the same issue at our admin offices and several of our other facilities. We've also had leaks at John Daly Library this winter. And again, we were fortunate that it didn't affect any of the collection or equipment. Lost some tiles and some stains on the carpet, but we were fortunate. So the need is there. Let me approach the answer to this in two ways. Because we've identified the problem with leveraging these funds is having the funds that you need in the match, we have scheduled a meeting with Supervisor David Canepa, Board of Supervisors, to at least explore the possibility of maybe having an exemption from the matching requirement. Transportation funding in the Bay Area, they have a thing called Community of Need, and they at the Metropolitan Transportation Commission actually look at census data and income, and that's how they identify communities of need. We have, in the past, for transportation purposes, had two communities in need identified in the region, and in San Mateo County, I'll tell you, there is only one other community of need. That's East Palo Alto. So hopefully if we use that methodology and have either through a extended interest-free loan or complete waiver of the matching fund, we might be able to leverage some of the money. That's tax dollars, a lot of which are collected right here in Daly City between Ceremony Shopping Center and Westlake Shopping Center and City Toyota. But that part of Measure A, the tax, the 1 cent tax, it's all collected by the county. And then mm-hmm. the Board of Supervisors is entrusted with distributing it. And not surprisingly, they keep the lion's share for county programs, which, you know, it's fair. They're important county programs that benefit the entire county. The hospital is probably the biggest. So if we're successful in making a compelling argument, perhaps the rules of getting to that money will change and we'll have a better shot at it. So the second part of the answer is, you know, I mentioned we have a laundry list that I could rattle off the top of our head of what we perceive as needs. The good thing is there are people that are better at making those assessments than the library staff, and the city is about to award a complete facilities assessment done by a third party of professionals that, believe it or not, that is a profession. That's what these people do. I was part of the panel that interviewed three finalists for the proposal, and these were pretty hefty, you know, 400 or 500 page proposals that they're making. And unless something changes in the next 24 hours or 48 hours, that should be on the city council's agenda for the award of that contract at their meeting on Monday, February 27th. It's a very ambitious schedule. They hope to complete maybe as soon as by the end of the summer. That would provide a roadmap of sorts with the priorities called out of those, especially in any life safety issues that may need to be addressed. You know, those would rank first. Mm-hmm. But certainly things like leaky roofs and ADA accessibility issues that we know that we have some of those too, would probably rank fairly high. The capital improvement or in the capital projects budget for the city of Daly City is a team effort that mostly is driven by our public works department. And the public works department makes sense. They are the department within the city that is tasked with maintaining all of our facilities. So they're in all of the buildings, and in conjunction with the finance department, and ultimately adopted by the city council biannually with the mm-hmm. regular budget. So hopefully this document that will come out of the facilities assessment will favor libraries. Chayla's nodding her head. Because, you know, we certainly know there's some need. You know, in addition to the leaks we've had at Ceremony ongoing, at John Daly, we have some serious and expensive HVAC issues at the Westlake branch. You know, you can look at the carpeting at probably all the libraries. Another, you know, pet peeve of mine too is the lighting, especially at Ceremony. There are way too many light fixtures, and we have met with PG&E and they have corroborated all this that, yeah, the building is ripe for an energy makeover and, you know, for more efficient lighting and maybe a change in the design too, because not unlike the diffusers directly above you, they're, you know, 1970s vintage. They're not anything you can find off the shelf, and to have them custom made to replace the existing is really cost prohibitive. So there's certainly opportunities at Ceremony. And then my number one dream of all that I've been repeating since the day I took this job is an elevator at Ceremony Library. We have a beautiful community room that yeah. is really difficult to get down to if you have any sort of physical challenges. There's stairs on the exterior, stairs on the interior. Mm-hmm. It's a perfect place to be doing story time. It's, you know, those of you who've seen story time at the library, it really becomes congested and there's strollers everywhere. It's hard to bring an infant up and down the stairs too. Yeah. So an elevator would really, really be helpful to modernize Ceremony. You know, we're taking baby steps. The bathroom is beautiful. We've you know, the new children's area is beautiful. Working on upgrading a teen area. The elevator would sure be nice.
Yeah.
So Those are some of the highlights. We've talked about some of the furniture issues, which wouldn't rise to the occasion. Just by way of definition, a capital project defined by the City of Daly City are those improvements with a price tag of $50,000 or more. Some of our issues aren't quite that extensive, but certainly maybe, you know, the one-time expenses that we could leverage Measure A/K for would be beneficial. So the highlights, February 27th, unless something changes, the award of contract to get the ball rolling on the facilities assessment, and then on March 16th, staff-to-staff meeting with Supervisor Canepa, and then we can report back on those at our next meeting in March.
Okay, any questions or comments from the board? Well, thank you for that. Do you guys understand Measure K and what it intends to do, what its general opportunities are, as well as its limitations?
Not really.
I don't either, frankly. Mm. And it's what I was hoping is that we would also, and maybe this was an unexpressed hope, so I'm not saying you should have come to say or to address this, but to have some sort of presentation on this so that we understand what we're talking about
Okay. When
we talk about Measure K monies and opportunities.
Is this going out?
It's a 1 cent sales tax collected in San Mateo County. It is collected by the county of San Mateo, controlled by the Board of Supervisors. Most of that money is already programmed. They do have set aside some that up until now has been sort of a competitive grant basis award. And so you could submit, you know, if you had a capital project, like South San Francisco had a rather extensive one, but you have to have the matching funds to it. So the problem that's kept us from leveraging that money is our lack of funds to
match. My concern is that the match is a limitation on our thinking, not so much on our planning. You know, that becomes a barrier, and we kind of say, well, gee, this is pretty insurmountable. You know, I'd like to set that problem aside temporarily until we look at what our real needs are and what our, you know, even some of our dreams might be that could be possibly realized under Measure K, and then try and think creatively about whether or not a match is feasible and not invest a great amount of time into the ideas that we have as much as talk about them, and then see which ones we might want to pursue in a creative fashion. You know, as discussed somewhat at the Public Library Associates meeting today, consideration of bonds, grants, external funding of other sources, and not
change,
just the
changing
city,
the rules,
not just the city.
Recognizing our limitations, I think, would be really effective if we're successful.
Well, this is part of why, you know, I'm interested in a more, detailed explanation of what Project K allows us to do and says you can't do, because I know there's a match, but, you know, I don't know if the match absolutely has to come from the city or if the city can leverage money from other sources that it can then use as its match. I mean,
the answer is yes, of course we could.
Well, okay, but see, you know the answer, but we don't know the answer. Okay. So I'm hoping that, you know, you can come back and give us more detailed information about the measure.
Sure.
Either in terms of bullet points, something also that we can take away that's tangible. We don't just hear and then kind of fades away between this meeting and the next.
We'll summarize it in a PowerPoint format next time. We can, you know, I won't have the results of the facilities assessment. We can give you,
of course,
what we know to be our deficiencies. There's probably many more that we don't know of because, you know, we're not architects and engineers, but and we can go through the rules,
right,
of when applications are submitted and what they can be used for and what they can't be used for. We can do that.
All right, great. Even maybe an example or two of things that other communities have done, you know, within San Mateo County using these funds, so that we've got an idea of the possibilities.
There's a terrific website that I didn't bring the address for tonight.
And Lynn is also a resource for this, as I recall.
Because, yeah. because I'm on the Measure A committee for District 5, but it's a great website that I can share with you to share with the city or whatever, that you can actually go in and drill down all the way down to what each city has done with the funds, where it's at now, when it started, when it's projected to be finished, and how much money is still in the pot, because it is going to go for another 20 years now.
Right.
So I can meet with you.
Well, I was wondering if this is something that you would be willing to look into and bring back as a report at the next meeting.
Yeah,
so that everybody has all of the information, and it's not a case of Alyssa read it and Lily didn't, and
No, so and I'm happy to share it. That could be a whole meeting for months, but I'll see what I can pull together.
Lynn, can you go ahead and just share the website, and maybe we could just look
it
up?
I didn't bring it with me, but
oh,
I will.
Okay.
I'll get your emails and
sounds
we'll
good.
Figure something out. But I was not prepared to talk about it tonight.
Oh, I know. I wasn't asking.
No, it's good. I mean, when I saw we were at the meeting a couple of weeks ago for mm-hmm. the Measure A, and there's actually a meeting, the board is meeting on the 28th, Canapa Board of Supervisors are meeting on the 28th to go over the budget and all. So, I mean, you're welcome to come down there and sit in on the meeting, which I hope to do, and get a lot more insight on it. But it took a little while for me to wrap my head around everything that was going on. So I'm not saying that I'm smarter or nobody's going to pick it up as fast, but the website really drills and drills and drills. And when I saw it in the meeting the last time we were there, I just thought you can spend days going through this and seeing what's happening. It's all good. So it's a lot to learn in this high school student. But it'll be worth it.
The very good news is
yeah.
all the projections for when they were implementing Measure A, they were hoping about $60 million a year. With the uptick in the economy, they've exceeded that by about $20 million. So they're actually bringing in about $80 million mm-hmm. a year. So, again, a lot of that is going to county projects, but it does
and
put
projects,
a little bit
yeah.
more money out there that they have some discretion over. And
it's been a very successful program, so, yeah. But it is more county. But the whole county's benefiting, and
right.
our city's benefiting from it, too. So, yeah.
All right. Any other thoughts or comments?
Yeah.
All right. We'll move on to reports from the Daly City Public Library Associates meeting, which I attend. It did meet earlier today at 11 at the Ceremony Library Community Room. First item of discussion was the St. Patrick's Day event. This is an annual event. This year it's going to be Tuesday, March 14th. It's an opportunity to invite members of the Daly City Public Library Associates to come together.
You're invited to join.
For free lunch. Well, they are joining, in fact. So, because you're joining in the near future, you probably won't receive an invitation other than the one tonight. I only have one flyer, so I'm sure.
Oh, you can give it to, because I already know about the luncheon.
Okay, there you go.
We're attending.
And I don't know, since that's during the school day, whether or not you have any flexibility to get out and join us.
I'll try to.
But, if you can, please do. It's really a nice event.
Mm-hmm.
We also talked about a book sale. The book sale had been scheduled for sometime in the future. I don't recall exactly when, but the discussion was to move it up into May, because there's an opportunity in, is it called the Colma Center? 280 Metro, thank you. We'll have a large community event, which will bring a lot of people out. And, of course, that's what we want for the book sale. So it looks like the book sale is going to be advanced to this May date. Excuse me. It also looks like the Jefferson Elementary School District will again hold a poster contest for children.
Oh, that was cute.
I'm sure if the board approves. It was very successful the last time. Also discussed was the possibility of a soapbox derby-like event in conjunction with Skyline College. One of the newest members of the Public Library Associates is the Vice President for Administration, I believe. And it looks like it might be possible to hold this event on Skyline College property. There's parking and an area with a slope that would allow these cars to go zooming down and be involved in a nice contest. All of these are seen as ways to raise funds for the Public Library Associates, which have contributed approximately $135,000 to the library for a variety of important projects and purchases over the past 5 years. It was also announced that, excuse me, at the February 27th council meeting.
Do you want me to get you some more?
I've got more water here.
Okay.
What is described as a collection boost grant funded at $5,000 will be awarded.
He needs cough drop more.
It's catching. The executive director also reported on the opening of the Westlake Branch library space for youth. On January 26th, librarian at the Westlake Branch named Colleen has worked very hard on that. It was very successful, and it's a nice room, nice facility. And the youth donated a banner to DCPLA in appreciation. Because I'm having trouble talking, the next item that was discussed or reported on was the library report from Joseph and Shayla on items that will be presented at the St. Patrick's Day lunch under the category of fund the need. So would one of or both of you talk about those three items, please?
We did talk about three items that we hope to raise funds for at the March 14th St. Patrick's Day luncheon. The first is a new book drop for the Westlake Library. It's been problematic for a very long time, especially on holiday weekends, and now that we're closed routinely on Mondays. The accumulation of books overwhelms the existing infrastructure there, so we're hoping to come up with a new receptacle. We've toyed with the idea of making it outside and possibly a drive-up service. We're not married to that. It was just an idea. So that would be one item. The other item, we talked about how, believe it or not, the beautiful Bayshore Library, which seems like it's still brand spanking new to us, is now 11 years old. It opened in February 2006, and some of the well-worn furniture in the children's area could use some replacing and repurposing. So that would be item number two. And our third item, the fish at the Westlake Library. That was something that we didn't budget for in the library's budget last go-round, and the fish were saved, so to speak, through a generous donation of Kaiser Permanente through DCPLA. That was a one-time gift. We're hoping that the fish have a longer future with us, so we're hoping the good people at the St. Patrick's Day luncheon will reach into their pockets and support the fish and provide them with a clean, healthy environment for at least another year or two. Those are the three items for the fund the need. Again, that's March 14th, the DCPLA St. Patrick's Day luncheon at the Colma Community Center from 11:30 to 1:30.
Thank you very much. Any questions? Thanks for taking over. Thank you for taking over. I feel much better now. Any announcements or communications? I think we've built the agenda as we've gone through the meeting, so we'll pass by that meeting or that that item. We're at public comment. I'd like to invite Mayor Glenn Sylvester to speak. And given the size of our audience, we will not be enforcing the two-minute rule tonight.
There's three.
Yeah.
There.
Don't worry, Pam. We got you.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I'd like to welcome the new members to the Library Board of Trustees. I was at the meeting this morning for the DCPLA, and I wanted to say that being at the meeting and seeing the wide range of the folks who are on the board, I can feel an internal passion about the love that they have for our libraries here in Daly City. I definitely felt that. And I'm learning to try to become involved in the various committees, not only the libraries, but the other various committees within Daly City. And the only way that you can understand is to get involved. But getting back to the DCPLA, I've attended a few council meetings throughout the past year. And President Lex, thanks for the reminder as to how much has been donated by the DCPLA over the years. And being part and seeing the council meetings, I've been a witness to that as well. And I don't see how you folks do it. And now getting to the Measure A and K funds, I'm in the process of learning also. And as I made mention earlier at the meeting, if we can come together and collaborate, as Director Curran had said earlier about the deferred maintenance, capital improvements that our libraries so sorely need, we need to advocate all together. So to send a message, because there was a recently retired Honorable Adrienne Tissier, who was also part of the DCPLA, and she provided good information as to the money that's out there. If you don't ask, you don't get. So let's move forward. I am here to support you folks as well. I want to say thank you, and thank you for everything the DCPLA has done for the Daly City and what you folks also do for the libraries. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, and thank you for your comments. And again, let me recognize that we have community members in the audience who are part of that support group and part of the reason that we've been able to raise that money. My goodness, it's a busy night.
I'd also just like to say thank you so much to Susan Brisenden-Smith, whose untiring passion for the DCPLA is really the glue that holds it together. So Susan, if you're watching, bless you.
Okay, I will call Pam DiGiovanni up. Do you want to defer, Pam?
To the Vice Mayor.
Okay, certainly. Okay, Vice Mayor Manalo, would you like to make a few remarks?
Thank you. Good evening, Board of Trustees, President Lex and Vice President Shimbuka, and our newly appointed Board of Trustees. I just want to say thank you for your dedication over the years, for those of you that have served generously of your time and dedication and passion for the libraries. As a recipient when I was way younger and utilized the libraries at John Daly when it was a library and now a museum, and also at Westlake when I went to Ben Franklin Middle School, it's definitely such care that the community has around ensuring that the libraries are sustained and that the youth and the elders have a place to go to. I had the fortunate opportunity to be at the teen grand opening around updating the furniture and seeing just the young people's eyes and energy around even just updating a space for them is truly special. So thank you to DCPLA for a lot of their dedication and really putting forth a way to help the libraries. As our mayor has stated, we are here to support all of you and your endeavors, and please reach out to me at any time. My phone number is 650-713-4322, and that goes out to also folks out there in the audience. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Vice Mayor Manalo. And thank you for mentioning that you are at that opening at the Westlake Branch. It's my oversight to not have recognized you for that, and to thank you and the mayor and other council members for their involvement in activities like that. Going with seniority, so to speak, I'll next recognize Marie Rizuela for public comment.
Seniority in what? No, that's good. I'd like to say a few words about what you guys are doing. I'm really happy that we have new blood here, too, because we need it. We need young blood, which is great for you. I just wanted to say that the Daly City Public Library Associates, I always have to stop to think about that, they came up and followed something that was here for a long, long time, which was the Friends of the Daly City Library. And I had the opportunity, quite by accident, my husband used to deliver the books to the big book sale that was at Our Lady of Mercy that went for like 2-3 days. And so when it started going down, a little downhill, some of the members were getting older, they called my husband to ask him to go to a meeting. So they were hoping to get him involved. He said, no. He says, you go, honey. So I went and I got hooked on it, and I really loved it. And we did a lot of fundraising. We didn't make as much as you guys make because we're a smaller group, and those days you collected less money. But it meant a difference to the schools, to the kids, to the public, to the seniors, to all those that really love to read a book, that would rather go to a library and take a book out and read instead of buying a very expensive book and then it sits on the shelf. Mm-hmm. My dad was one of those who belonged to a book club and bought all these books, and he had more books than you could ever imagine. Most of them went to the library after he passed on. But those books would sit there. Maybe he'd read it again a second time, maybe he wouldn't. Mm-hmm. And I tell him one day, go to the library. So he started going to the library, and I think he was a pest once in a while when he went there, but he learned how much better it was to go to the library, see somebody that would help him out, get a book, read it, return it. And it means a lot to people. You mentioned as a child, I had the same thing after school. We went to the library. And it means a lot. And when I hear people say, we don't need the libraries, I feel sad because it's really important to the community. And I thank you very much. And I've been around long enough to see a lot of the libraries remodeled, the new ones coming in, and it's great. And we, Friends of the Library ourselves, also bought furniture for the libraries. And when you talk about, Mayor Sylvester mentioned about reaching out to other people, we got a grant for $10,000 by accident. They called me and said, hey, you're involved with the libraries. Do you want to do something that you could, help children for reading? I said, well, by golly, it happens to be the right person because I represent the schools and the libraries. And we had a great program going to Ceremony Library, teaching them about the environment, about the, correct me if I can remember how it says it. Yeah. And the children loved learning about it. The presentation was great. It was all free for the children. And then the bank is the one that gave it to us, bank in Westlake, the one that's a Chinese name.
First National?
Yeah. They just said, we got this money, we want to give it to you. So I filled out the grant. Very easy to do when you knew they wanted you. And they took us, and it paid for books, paid for the program, and the Friends of the Library provided the refreshments for the children, and they had such a good time. And we reached out to the schools, and we gave them little certificates saying that they completed a course by going to learn about it, went back to school, wrote stories about it. So it engaged education all the way around. There's other groups out there that are willing to do it. Let's work together and reach out and do more, because it was something that was just handed to us. We didn't have to beg for it. So I think there are groups that want to help, and if we reach out to them, they certainly will be partners. So call me if you need some help. And if not,
and your phone number is.
I'm not going to say it out loud because it's going over the air. I didn't know I was on TV until a few minutes ago. But no, I think you know where to find me.
Okay. I do.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Marie. Pam?
Thank you. Hi, I just want to say thank you for the opportunity and to thank you publicly for serving our community. People go unsung heroes. We have a lot of great community members here. And Bill Lex and Lynn Shimbanka, she was in my citizens school. And Lily will be great. And it's great to see all of you. Congratulations. I look forward to looking for those grants. And also that recently we had a grant, I believe, part of it was a grant for a church here that got a recent elevator and for ADA compliance. And so we may want to look at that, and I think that they also would probably be willing to help our libraries as well and our seniors. So that might be something to look into as well. So you can probably get that information from our Supervisor Canepa, and he has some information on that. And I want to thank you publicly for that and look forward to what you guys will do. And it helps education. It helps our community. It's nice to see the seniors even come to the library. It's a relaxing place. For people can come and read a book, and you know, everything's expensive these days, but reading is free. So we can come in and take our minds off the stress that we are living under during these times and just give a break and support our libraries. So thank you for your public service. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, Pam. Before we adjourn, let me just mention to our newest members that there is a Daly City website, and within that website, there is a portion devoted to the library and the Board of Trustees. And if you've explored it, you'll notice that there is a section where you talk a little bit about your background so that people in the community know more about the board and who's on it and what their passions are or what their background is, what their experience base is. So I would encourage you to write a personal statement and to submit that, would it be to Joseph or to Chayla?
I put yours up, I can put theirs up.
Okay.
Either one.
Mr. Curran?
Every time I have to put it to
And Lynn will get hers done here.
when did the Westlake branch open, do you remember?
Originally or after?
Originally. Was it in the 50s? So I think I went to the opening. Yeah. I'm only 29, but.
They also had another grand opening when they remodeled it.
Oh yeah, no, growing up, I mean, I've been at the branch when the Dewey Decimal System was popular, when rocks were soft. But it's a great library, so, yeah.
All right, so sign up for the Daly City Public Library Associates. Get your personal statement written and submitted with a photograph.
It's on my to-do list.
And we'll look forward to getting this jolly group together again in 1 month.
Okay.
Any other business or comments? Meeting is adjourned.